So I just got dropped off by Letterman. That was an amazing stay. They were great hosts. You know, it's kind of neat when someone has hiked the trail and knows what a hiker needs, and aside from just being great hosts, but that was wonderful. So I am back on trail. I'm at about mile 1240, I think. No, 1140. And got about 20 miles scheduled today. So that's the longest day I've ever scheduled. But, you know, we'll just see how it goes. I'm going to get me on track to get into town over the weekend. And should be in the town on Friday. But let's just worry about today. But it's a beautiful day, cooling off a little bit. Supposed to have great wet weather this week. So I'm very thankful to be out here. And it's a Monday morning, and I'd rather be doing this than going to work. So I'm thankful for that. Made it down that rocky mountain. I think I started with a little bit of the rock from Pennsylvania. Dang, dude. Better deliver the mail. Yeah, that was pretty tedious. I didn't video it. It was kind of difficult to see, but every step you kind of had to watch where you were stepping. And I don't even know if I've gotten to, you know, the worst of it, but just another part of it. But we're going in here to Duncannon. Oh, and up on top of that mountain, talking to this guy. Joker's from Eastman, Georgia. I told him I was from Warner Robins, and so we had a talk about high school football and that kind of stuff. It's crazy. It's one of the reasons I like asking people where they're from, because sometimes you get surprised by it. When I told him that my wife's family was from Empire, you know, he thought that was cool. Go Empire. This is the booming metropolis of Duncannon. Pretty old town, kind of drying up. Now, I will not have the opportunity to stay or eat in the Doyle because it's closed, but that's a kind of an iconic place, the Doyle Hotel in Duncannon. Now check this out. Here's the trail. And my man here, this is his house. Trail goes literally right out by his front door.
Yeah.
Take it easy, brother. Well, I tell you, I'm not sure really what I was expecting coming through Duncannon, but this wasn't it. All the other towns that the trail's gone through, it's kind of down the main street, but this actually kicks up a block from what looks like the main street, and I'm just right by these houses, and these people are just hanging out, and everybody's very friendly, so it's a really friendly, neat little town, but very interesting, for sure. Wasn't what I was expecting. Not good or bad, just not what I was expecting. Tell you what, usually I kind of like going through towns and finding the blazes and all that, but I'm ready to get back in the woods. That was pretty intense. There we go. All right, I'm still not going to talk bad about Pennsylvania because we all have our blemishes, but I understand the reputation of rocks. There's the trail, and the video probably doesn't demonstrate it, but it's just a matter of picking through these boulders, and it's just been this way for all along this ridge. This is kind of an example. So you get right here and then, okay, there's a blaze. Yeah, down there. And it's kind of fun, but it just keeps going. It doesn't stop. Gonna share the decision I'm having to make. I have made it to a shelter. Not a really nice shelter. I'm down here at the spring now, getting some water. There's good flow in the water. But I'm about 6, almost 7 miles to the next shelter. It is 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm feeling pretty good. I don't want to get three or four miles in and think, what have I done? But I have decided to go on. I'm going to go on to this next shelter. If I have crazy rocks, it may slow me down, so I might not get there until dark. But we'll just deal with it. I'm afraid if I don't go to the shelter, I'm a planner, and maybe it's a weakness out here, but I know if I don't get there tonight, I will be trying to make up that time for the next 5 days. So I'm just going to kind of bust it out tonight, and so we'll see how it plays out. To be continued. All right, about to take off, but I did want to clarify because some of you guys may be thinking, and I'll look back at this and say, well, I could always tent. And I very well may tent, but on far out, it didn't list any tent sites. Now, many times you can find tent sites without it being on the app, but there's just a chance it's not there. So I know I'm taking a little bit of a risk, but I don't think it's a crazy risk because, like I said, it's just past 4. I got a little over 6 miles. So we'll see. So far, so good. How about that view? Yep, there's the bridge way down there that I was on a little while ago. There was actually a lot of variables that I had going through my head. Water was an issue. Of course, daylight's an issue. I have food for 4 nights. And if I didn't make it to this shelter, I'd have to make it up at some point. And so I just decided I'm just going to bust it out tonight. And we'll see what happens. So I do hope it was a wise choice. So it's been an hour. The terrain hasn't been that bad. I've been able to keep a pace of about 2 miles an hour. So I've got a little less than 5 miles to go. So we'll see. Because see, that was the thing that far out tells me the elevation change, but it doesn't tell me. And I knew if I was going to hit all these rocks that I was going to really slow down. But so far, so good. I'll let you know in an hour. Hour check-in, Peters Mountain Shelter, which is where I'm heading, 3 miles. And it is 6 o'clock. So I should get there by 7:30. It's almost 7 and I'm less than a mile. It's getting kind of dark, but I think this is gonna be the right call. So I'm thankful the terrain wasn't horrible. I did make it to the shelter last night and I had a good night's sleep. And on the trail this morning, not really much happening. Just about 17 mile day, something like that, through another shelter. So we'll just see what the day holds. It is almost 1 o'clock on Monday, and these plains have been, I think it's the same plane just circling, but it has been doing it for about at least 20, 30 minutes. So I don't know if that means anything, but I'm just recording this. All right, nothing much captured today. It's just been a long day of hiking, just getting miles in, but let me show you the shelter. This is Rouse Gap Shelter. And I don't know if I've seen one like this, kind of interesting, but table, don't have a picnic table, but fire pit, water right here though, That's nice. And it's pretty woods. Fall is definitely here. Leaves are cluttering the trail and making it pretty, turning yellow. Slept pretty good last night. It's about 0.3 miles back to the AT. With a trail name like U-Turn, I have to build in some accommodations. So, see that arrow I made? That tells me that's the way I go this morning. In the school world, we call that a 504 plan. Another pretty long day today, a little over 17 miles. So this is three long days for me in a row, but we're making it. Supposed to be coming up to something pretty interesting where a stream is. Some beavers have made a dam and flooded the area. And if I'm not mistaken, we go right over the dam on the trail. So the actual AT, you can see it says water crossing beaver dam ahead. And I think you actually go over the dam. Now there is an alternate route, alternate dry route. I did talk to a guy yesterday that said he would have done the dam, but he did the alternate route. And I'm thinking, I don't want my feet to get wet, but dadgum, how many opportunities do you get to walk over a beaver dam? That's why I'm out here. So we're gonna do the beaver dam. Looks like we're getting into the flooded area here, and you can see where hikers leave these sticks to help folks. Well, I have my own trekking pole, so we're gonna go on. But when beavers build a dam, of course it's a home for them, but it backs up all the water, and that's why you get real marshy area behind the dam, up creek. And so it's all just kind of flooded back here. Kind of spooky. I'm gonna have to maneuver through this. Obviously I'm gonna put the phone up, but we'll see. I can see a blaze way on the other side, and hoping I don't get feet wet, but we shall see. Be right back. Dry feet. Just took my time, step by step. It was like a little obstacle course. And like a lot of things, this isn't exactly what I thought it was gonna be, but that's why you do it and figure out what it is. So, dam completed. Just noticed that, you know, when you get started, just like you're over your first 100, first 200 miles or whatever, that's kind of cool. But I am I'm getting closer to the end of at least where my Aunt Mary's is and granddaddy lives and all that. And I am within 100 miles. That's almost hard to believe. So, congratulations to me. Tell you, you drive over the interstate and a bridge, you don't think anything about it. But look at all this work. That's impressive. This is an example of the rocks of Pennsylvania. Not sure if you can see, there's a blaze right there. And this is just crossing a boulder field, working your way to get there. So it's not boring, that's for sure.
I couldn't believe when you said it. I'm thinking, where, what?
This is the 501 shelter. This is the shelter I stayed in last night. Me and one other guy, he slipped out before I even woke up. little skylight up here. Kind of interesting. Another day of just getting the miles in today. Only have about 14 miles today, but going to another shelter. It's weather's been nice. Weather's supposed to come in this weekend, but we're gonna enjoy the nice weather while we got it. And so that's really all that's happening here. Fall has definitely arrived. So this route has been, there was a sign that this was a reroute because they needed to reestablish the growing on the trail. So they did a good job with making the trail, but look at these blazes. You'd think they would have done a little bit better. Watch me be laughing and I'm not even on the right trail. I don't think that's right. Time for a little rant. A lesson learned at the end. The rant is, these rocks will drive you absolutely nuts. You can't get in a rhythm. You have to watch every step. I mean, my feet are so sore and banged up. I saw that snake yesterday, so that's got me aware. The leaves are all on the trail. So, I say all that to say this. What am I going to do? I got to persevere. Verse I was looking at this morning was out of 2 Peter, and it was all these steps to get to perseverance was one of those things that you were looking for, and I am learning about perseverance. So, we're going to press on, and but I also learned, don't talk about stuff before you do it. How I was saying, oh, the rocks aren't that bad. These things are obnoxious. Here at the shelter, and don't do it very often, but I got here early enough and some good opportunities. So I said, you know what? I'm gonna do a little campfire. So campfire's going. And so far by myself in the shelter, it's about 5:30. So I'll enjoy a little fireside TV. And Lord willing, some good sleep. Another great day.
So heading out in the rain this morning, I stayed nice and dry in the shelter. Didn't sleep real good. I think I'm just kind of excited about a lot of things happening and getting close to the end and getting home. And so mine was racing and just didn't sleep real well. But anyway, so I got about 8 miles into town and I'm looking forward to a shower. And because it's been 4 nights since I've been out, and so into a shower, and in Port Clinton, Pennsylvania. So we'll see what it's all about. Probably not much video until I get there, but we'll see.
I have made it down to the railroad tracks here at Port Clinton. Not really exactly sure where I'm going now, but I'm gonna tell you, I'm tired, I'm whooped. So I've been out there in the woods 5 days. My feet are really sore, my knees are sore, I'm mentally fatigued. But you know what, I had a friend call me and just said it, I was on his mind and called and prayed with me, and it was not very, very well timed, and I appreciate that, John. But I'm here in Port Clinton, I plan on staying at the restaurant, and well, there's a restaurant and then a hotel there, and I'm actually gonna take a zero tomorrow, so. Then we'll move on one last little leg before I get to Granddaddy's house.